Good morning, and welcome to St. Michael's School Mass. At this time, we ask that all cell phones be silenced. As we enter into prayer, please stand. Join us singing our open song, Alleluia, Love is Alive.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which, through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith we may possess in unending love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The followers of Jesus all felt the same way about everything. None of them claimed that their belongings were their own, and they shared everything they had with each other. In a powerful way, the apostles told everyone that the Lord Jesus was now alive. God greatly blessed his followers, and no one went in need of anything. Everyone who owned land or houses would sell them and bring the money to the apostles. Then they would give the money to anyone who needed it. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of John. Beloved, if we believe that Jesus is truly Christ, we are God's children. Everyone who loves the Father will also love his children. If we love and obey God, we know that we will love his children. We show our love for God by obeying his commandments, and they are not hard to follow. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The disciples were afraid of the Jewish leaders, and on the evening of that same Sunday, they locked themselves in a room. Suddenly, Jesus appeared in the middle of the group. He greeted them and showed them his hands and his side. When the disciples saw the Lord, they became very happy. After Jesus had greeted them again, he said, "I am sending you just as the Father has sent me." Then he breathed on them and said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive anyone's sins, they will be forgiven. But if you don't forgive their sins, they will not be forgiven." Although Thomas the twin was one of the 12 disciples, he was not with the others when Jesus appeared to them. So they told him, "We have seen the Lord." But Thomas said, "First I must see the nail scars in his hands and touch them with my finger. I must put my hand where the spear went into his side. I won't believe unless I do this." A week later, the disciples were together again. This time, Thomas was with them. Jesus came in while the doors were still locked and stood in the middle of the group. He greeted his disciples and said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and look at my hands. Put your hand into my side. Stop doubting and have faith." Thomas replied, "You are my Lord and my God." Jesus said, "Thomas, do you have faith because you have seen me? The people who have faith in me without seeing me are the ones who are really blessed." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you. We have in our gospel story two scenes happening in the same place. And in the first scene, someone is missing. Who is missing in the first scene? What's his name? Who is missing in the first scene?
Thomas.
Thomas. Thomas is missing. And so when Thomas is missing, What happens in the story? What happens while Thomas is missing?
Jesus comes and blesses the other disciples.
Jesus comes and blesses the other disciples. Now, this story is happening after the crucifixion, after Jesus gave up his life for us on the cross. This is after then Easter. This is after Jesus has risen from the dead. So he is teaching his disciples, I am alive. And so Thomas was missing when Jesus was there to show them that he is alive, that he is risen. And so then in between these two scenes, Thomas meets with some of these other disciples. And does Thomas believe or not believe? Oh, now we get a hand raised in seventh grade.
Not.
He does not believe. And so then Thomas is then with the disciples later. And what does our Lord do? Does our Lord scold Thomas? Does our Lord help Thomas? What does our Lord do for Thomas?
Tells him to believe.
He tells him to believe. Our Lord also says here, you said you need to see the nail marks. You need to see where the spear injured my side. Here, look, believe. And so what we learn from our gospel story today is that our Lord comes and meets us. He comes and finds us when we are struggling, when we are finding it difficult to believe, to know that he loves and cares for us. He comes and finds us. And in his love, in his mercy, he helps us with what we need so that we can believe. Because this Easter is so important. Jesus' resurrection is so important for us because it changes everything. Yes, when Jesus died on the cross, it was scary and all of his disciples were terrified and most of them ran away and Peter even denied knowing Jesus. But now Jesus is sharing with us, yes, that was scary. But that is over now. I am risen. I am alive. I have conquered sin for you. I have set you free from sin. You are free now to live a new life. And this is wonderful. This is what Jesus is sharing with us. And when we struggle, Jesus comes and helps us to have faith. He doesn't just leave us alone to struggle. He helps us when a faith is difficult. And so we are given so many things. We are given our teachers who help us to understand our faith. We are given our family who help us to understand our faith. We come here to church, to Mass, every week as St. Michael's School, where we get to hear from Jesus' word. We get to hear it explained to us by the priests. And so we get to have our faith helped by our God. And so today, we can rejoice. We can rejoice because Jesus is alive, and this changes everything, and this is wonderful news. Good, great news. And we know that when we struggle, our God gives us the help that we need. He takes care of us. He loves us, and he is kind and merciful. And so we know that Jesus is risen, and we celebrate, and this is a wonderful thing. Knowing that Jesus is risen, we can trust God our Father with all of our needs.
Church, that the body of Christ may always be of one heart and one mind, we pray.
Glorious God, hear our prayer.
For the world, that the gifts may be shared so that everyone has what they need, we pray.
Glorious God, hear our prayer.
For those who live in fear, especially those who face political persecution, may they know peace, we pray.
Glorious God, hear our prayer.
For all the newly baptized throughout the world, that they may faithfully follow Jesus and keep the light of Christ burning in their lives, we pray.
Glorious God, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Father Joe Zamari, and for Tom McCoy, for whom this Mass is offered, may they know the life of the risen Christ forever in heaven, we pray.
Heavenly Father, we know that you love and care for us, for you sent your Son Jesus to teach us this. So we ask that you please hear and answer these prayers that we offer you in his name, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As the gifts are being prepared, please join us in singing The Risen Christ.
Creation, that's all. We below in
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Michael the Archangel, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, and the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As we come together in communion, let us sing together, Set Us Free.
Stay like
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
As we go out in peace and joy, let us sing, everybody, sing Alleluia.
Walking in the dark, could not see the light. Jesus came into my life and made everything alright. Everybody. Everybody sing hallelujah. Everybody praise his name. Everybody sing hallelujah. Praise his name today. Everybody sing hallelujah. Everybody praise his name. Everybody sing hallelujah. Praise his name today. There's a love that's in my heart, I'm hoping I will see. If you let it in your life, set your spirit free. Everybody sing hallelujah. Everybody praise his name. Everybody sing hallelujah. Praise his name today.
Hallelujah.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
Again, one more time.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. So I want to thank you, Lord, for all you've given me. Dancing in your spirit and singing joyfully. Everybody sing hallelujah. Everybody praise his name. Praise his name today.
One more time.
Praise his name today.